big Weasel little juice.
I feel like a duck-billed platypus.
Ow!
Dude, check out the knots.
It's the Leaning Tower of Cheesa.
Let's go, Tybalt! Great adventures await!
Hey, buddy. It's time for another Dystopian Dance Party mini-sode. And this time we are celebrating Pauly's giving. Weasel's giving.
Weasgiving. That's
Weasgiving.
That's what they would have said in 1990. Yeah.
Yeah.
We have a really good one for Christmas that you're never going to guess, but I'm very excited about it.
So what did we do for Thanksgiving? Well, we watched a bunch of Totally Pauly episodes. Totally Pauly fan actually conveniently made a playlist specifically for Totally Pauly and Totally Different Pauly Thanksgiving specials, which I wish I knew about for Halloween because I was manually finding them. But apparently Totally Pauly fan already has this covered and he has every Totally Pauly holiday special in their own playlist. So check that out. Shout out again to whoever
is behind that account is the real hero. Like, we're standing on the shoulders of giants. We're just like showing up and not doing any preparation and just like half-assing a podcast every roughly 2 weeks. We can't even really get it together to do it every 2 weeks, you know, but Totally Pauly fan is actually like archiving and doing a public service for not only us, but the world.
I was reading the description today and they're ripping all of this from VHS and they have like DVDs of Totally Pauly.
Yeah, this is like a multiple decade endeavor for them. So hats off.
Yeah, so I guess like they're archiving and we're just curating.
Right. Yeah, exactly. I guess it's
and critiquing.
Yeah, it's different skill sets. Spoiler alert, we're probably going to do the same thing in December, but for Christmas.
Oh, we're 100% going to do it because guess what? Totally Pauly fan does have a Christmas playlist. And I didn't watch any of them, but I did see like the cover photo for it and it looks
good. Pauly's
really
got to have,
I think some of those
he's
got
to have some Hanukkah episodes too, right?
I guess we'll find out. I didn't look through it. They were definitely Christmas.
A couple of quick comments to read. Both of them are from our last video. Both of them are from people we talked about in our last video. So Lee and Grace,
I think they're the only people both, who are watching.
Both chimed in. And they're kind of, I'm going to kind of deal with them together. So I'm going to read both of them and then I'm going to respond. So Lee said, thanks for Grace and I for the love. He said that video, the unboxing video that we put in our last minisode, has a major Easter egg in the form of a publicity picture of Pauly on an elephant from Encino Man on the organ in the background and a minor one in the form of Faith No More's epic 12-inch behind, featured in Biodome and episodes of Totally Pauly. I have to admit, I did not catch either of those. So you can go back and rewatch if you want to see it. And then he said, they can't believe the year of the weasel is almost done. You do have so much to cover yet. I feel like Pauly Shore is dead is essential to the story arc, but adopted as the best of his later work. Still, we joined late, so 9 months from now, we might be weaseled out. I kind of doubt it, though. I think you've worked him firmly into our culture.
I also can't believe the Year of the Weasel is almost done. When did we start?
We started it, so...
Oh, looks like February. Yeah, because it was around
we had a late launch. You know, like, we can't really get our shit together to do anything on time.
Because I was like, we're nowhere near.
No, we're kind of at the halfway point. And so that actually ties.
So it might be 2 years.
Yeah, I think that's basically what I'm leading up to, because Grace said, thanks so much for sharing my unboxing video. And she said, well, we have a spooky bogus witch project episode next. And this is, again, they're kind of schooling me a little bit on the late Pauly stuff, because I didn't even know about the bogus witch project. It's one of those kind of like the movie that we're doing next month that we didn't even fucking
we literally just new found movies. Out
of, but yeah, like we're adding movies to the rotation as we go.
Well, to be fair though, we didn't really know what we were gonna do for the last half. We were basically only sure about up to
Yeah, exactly. So Bogus Witch Project, I mean, why not? As far as I can tell, it's like a TV special that is obviously a Blair Witch Project parody, and I think Pauly hosted it. I don't know if it's as much of a vehicle as like a lot of the stuff we've been watching of him is. Honestly, Grace, you probably know better than us, so let us know. But I think we'll probably do it at some point. But yeah, basically, I know we've been billing this as 2024, but it's definitely going to go into 2025. Hopefully, it will be done by the end of 2025. But we got to do Pinocchio. Like, that's non-negotiable.
Yeah.
So...
I mean, I suppose we could speed it up and do 2 movies a month.
Yeah.
And actually, like, you know,
that's
do
true.
More.
We could stop doing. Maybe that's what'll happen in 2025. We'll pick up the pace a little bit and not be as leisurely with the minisodes and stuff. But I mean, yeah, we're seeing this through to the bitter end.
Although we're still kind of like transitioning out of Weasel
that's
territory.
True.
So maybe it's Year of the Weasel, and then 2025 is something different.
That's true.
It will still be Pauly Shore, but
yeah,
it's not
so
the Weasel.
So actually, we're just going to... This is now a permanent Pauly Shore podcast. It's no longer a year long. Yeah. We're just going to keep doing it. Okay, so let's talk about some Thanksgiving Totally Pauly stuff. I will say... I feel like the content for this one is not as compelling as Halloween, which is only fair because Thanksgiving is not as compelling as Halloween. It just isn't.
Yeah.
This is my favorite time of the year, you know, like basically starting from October through December. But if I'm ranking holidays, end of the year holidays, I guess if we're counting New Year's Eve, Thanksgiving is in second from the bottom, because New Year's Eve is definitely my least favorite.
Yeah, New Year's Eve sucks. I hate New Year's Eve. I don't even count it as a holiday.
But yeah, and the tier list, Christmas and Halloween are both far and away.
Christmas S.
Yeah. Then Halloween.
I like Thanksgiving because I like my mom's cooking, and then it's usually around my birthday. But it's not like, ooh, Thanksgiving.
Yeah, that is true.
It's like, oh, I'm going to get a good
I'm
meal.
I'm not going to sniff at a 4-day weekend. Like, I'm looking forward to Thanksgiving weekend, but I don't care about football. I'm not Thanksgiving pilled like that. So yeah, it's kind of a middling crop of Totally Pauly episodes. But, you know, even middling Totally Pauly is still better than Pauly, the TV show we did last episode. So so which one should we talk? Should we go chronological order, or should we go the order we watch them in?
I guess we should go chronological. So that would be, I think the first one was where he's bowling. He's doing the turkey bowling one. Is that the one? Or was it where he's at the homeless shelter?
So I think turkey bowling is the first. So this is, you know, just bog standard original Totally Pauly episode. He shows up at, where is he?
I don't know. A grocery store, I guess?
I just realized.
They don't really explain
he's
it.
He's at some kind of shopping center. And at first he starts talking to this guy who's like looking at shirts. And the guy's like,
I would like to buy this shirt.
Really? Are you going to get it?
No, it's just a slight bit too small.
Really? This seems like a pretty big shirt, man. You could get this, get into that.
Which is like a weird thing to say, because it's like, how do you fucking know? And then Pauly, of course, gets distracted, because if we've established anything about the Weasel, it's that he's extremely distractible.
Hey, what's that over there?
That's just the turkey bowling.
The what?
This is turkey bowling. They're there all the time.
Really?
Yeah.
Wait, dude. Have you ever heard of turkey bowling? No, but the Weez has never heard of turkey bowling. So cruise with me, we're going to turkey bowl. Excuse me, sir?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
The new sport of official sport of Thanksgiving, turkey bowling.
Tell them.
The official sport of Thanksgiving. I want everyone to do this holiday. Now, just take a quick look at this.
Turkey bowling?
It tenderizes the turkey for you ladies out there.
Okay, cool. Check it.
Oh, weak shot.
Dude. Turkey bowling. You guys want to watch me turkey? Can I turkey bowl too?
Yeah, you can. No problem.
Dude, it tenderizes the turkey for the nugs out there that like to munch in the turkey.
Doesn't he like run off with the turkey at the end?
Hey, he's got your shirt.
Bye, you guys. See you later.
Hey, come back.
I came when I got for it. I Weezed the shirt for my fat uncle Weez, and I got a turkey, buddy. Cool. See you guys later. Thanks. I'll see you tomorrow where I'm going to prepare this turkey. This is what I came here for, buds. Give me a turkey. I don't want to go turkey bowling. Come on, man. It's turkey bowling, dude. That is turkey bowling. That's creepy, buddies. But I got a shirt from that one dude that's got the rad furnace chilling. Cool, buddy.
Well, I know that in the next one where he... The next episode is that his mom left him alone for Thanksgiving and apparently left him a note that said, like, yeah, find food on your own for Thanksgiving. And one of the things is he's like...
See the show yesterday, I went turkey bowling and got a buff turkey to munch and cook up with my parents and stuff, and they all shined me with Windex, hardcore.
Yeah, this was my favorite of the episodes that we watched today. You know, it's classic. It's got the mom dynamic. He actually does a really solid Mitzi Shore impression at the beginning where yeah. He's reading the note that she supposedly left him.
It says, Pauly, I had to go out of town on Thanksgiving. Find something to eat on your own.
And then he pretty much spends he goes to this.
It's like a burger place. It's like kind of like a outdoor, like the old timey, like McDonald's.
Yeah, like a burger stand.
Eat at a counter kind of burger place.
Which is much more of a, I feel like those still exist in LA and pretty much nowhere else. But so he's going there and he basically spends the rest of the episode walking up to strangers and like whining that his mom ditched him and like trying to get them to take him home for Thanksgiving. It's a very vintage Weasel premise, you know.
What are you guys doing?
Getting a burger.
Yeah, I just getting a burger.
Really?
Yeah.
Are the burgers killer here?
Oh, good.
Really?
Hey,
but it's like, Thanksgiving.
It's the turkey's cooking.
What are you talking about?
There's turkeys in the oven, but there's just too many kids. I have family. I have grandkids. There's no room in my kitchen table for anybody.
Really? So you're basically saying I can't come and munch with you?
There's no room. That's why I'm over here.
No, here, come here. What's your name?
My name is Mary.
Hi, Mary.
Hi.
My name is Pauly.
Hi, Pauly.
And I'm a weasel. Sorry. Those are my buds. Okay, who are you eating today with, a little later with?
My husband and my son.
Really? Is there an extra place for me?
No.
Tell them.
No.
Say the weasel is stuck
solo.
And what about at your house?
Five children, eight grandchildren.
So tell him the weasel stuck solo.
Total solo. Grandma solo. I don't know.
What about you? What's your name?
My name is Marion.
Really? And I can't come much to watch. I'll give you a hug. You'll see. I could give warmth.
No.
Watch.
No, well, I didn't cook enough.
Yeah, but my mom left me a note. She denied me nothing. All I have to do is have a hamburger on Thanksgiving, man. I'm edge. Hardcore.
No.
Tamales.
Oh, yeah. So people are going to go, hey, Pablo, where'd you munch on Thanksgiving? Oh, dude, I gnawed on a tamale. Oh, that's going to be great.
Then he ends up having it, and he's raving about how delicious he is.
So I'm eating Thomas, and it's going to be a nectar, and I'm going to grind hardcore on the Thomas. You guys want a bite, too?
A couple times, he says.
So enjoy yourself on this Thanksgiving, while me, Pauly Shore, the stoniest dude you've ever witnessed, with the crustiest mop chilling on top of his melon, is gonna gnaw on a hamburger / dog at Tommy's.
That is like a reason for you to not be alone on Thanksgiving. Like, if you're the stoniest dude with the crustiest mop on top, there's no reason for you to be not at home for the holidays.
Yeah.
I had that on and I went into the kitchen to make tea and I heard that. It made me laugh because I have not been giving my undivided attention to any of these, I'll be honest with you, but I'll just have them on in the background and I'll just hear stuff.
I've got news for you. From here on, I don't know if I'm giving my undivided attention to anything. So if you're expecting perfect recall of what we're talking about, you've come to the wrong podcast. It's going to be half listening, half watching.
Notes. So basically, we're both going to be how I always am with the podcast. Right.
And a little bit, I feel like this is how the Weasel would do a podcast. Like, he's not going to extensively research. Yeah, I agree. You know?
Well, we've established that the Weasel is highly distractible.
I think definitely...
I, too, am highly distractible.
Definitely has some kind of... Like, I'm not a psychologist, but he definitely has some kind of learning disabilities, you know? I'm going to, when I'm going through any kind of mental hardship, this is going to be part of my monologue from now on. The stoniest dude with the crustiest mop on top should not be experiencing this. So yeah, that's the Alone on Thanksgiving one. And then we can talk about the homeless shelter one. I feel like that was actually, I feel like Totally Pauly Fan might have misplaced that because he kept saying Christmas.
Well, but he also said it's a little early for Christmas.
Okay, so maybe it technically aired on Thanksgiving.
So I think he was saying like this, I don't know if it was Thanksgiving, maybe it was after, but
that is kind of like, I don't know, to me, Thanksgiving is like the beginning of the Christmas season more than anything else. So it counts.
Yeah.
So this was like a surprisingly somber Totally Pauly.
Yeah, well, at the beginning he says,
"You want to laugh today on my show? It ain't going to happen." All right?
Which it's not that serious.
Like, that made me laugh, but it shouldn't have. I know. Well, and then it's like, so he is at a homeless shelter and he's like giving people
He's trying not to joke around too much.
There's like a couple things that are funny. One thing is that he's saying like,
"Most of you people have seen my show and you've seen that I've joked around a lot. And what I'm doing here is not a funny situation. I mean, it's funny that I'm like, you know, food and stuff, but it's not funny that I'm here downtown in LA."
and then another thing is that he keeps saying like,
"Because the thing is, it's not just in LA. It's not Detroit. Right. It's not New York. It's not the big city. There's farm towns. There's homeless people all over. All right. And they're not just, you know, old 90-year-old people. All right. There's people all over. You know, from 8, and that's why I'm talking to this guy. That's what blows me away about him. It's because he's dealing with people that are 18 and under, which is heavy.
That's right.
You know, because those are the people that watch the show, man. This isn't funny.
What was this stereotype that only old people are homeless?
I know.
I mean, I kind of get what he's.
MTV had to come.
I kind of get what he's saying because, like, the point he's trying to make is that, like, if you're watching Totally Pauly, you're probably a teenager or possibly younger.
But he was talking about 28-year-olds are the average age of people without homes are 28 right. years old. Like, so I'm like, they're not fucking watching Totally Pauly.
Yeah, he's trying to make a case that like MTV age people are also experiencing homelessness. But then the way he chooses to say it is he keeps saying 80 and 90 years. So it's just like,
yeah, he's like, it's not just 80 and 90-year-old people. And he said it like so many times.
And I like the part where he was serving the food and he kept like asking the guy he was serving with, he was like,
"This a good portion, bud?
That's good, right?
That guy's gonna be stoked to munch that too. That's cute."
So unfortunately this episode that we were not supposed to laugh and joke around in,
it was pretty funny. Yeah.
not for the reasons that, you know, it wasn't funny because of the homeless shelter. It's even funny because there's food, you know, and stuff.
Not funny, and then the other thing that was kind of funny was so this was at LA Mission, which I'm assuming Catholic, but like definitely a Christian charity. And every time they kept talking about Jesus, and you can like every time you can kind of see it in Pauly's face that he's like, "Oh, I didn't mean to go here."
This kind of place just helps you straighten out, you know, and it's okay to stay off of drugs and alcohol and all that kind of stuff.
the devil just takes all that away from you in the end anyway. So you can't keep money. He doesn't let you keep anything. The devil.
Who does?
The devil.
Oh, the devil.
He won't take. He won't. He won't let you keep anything.
Just the look in his eyes.
Yeah, that was. It's just like the tone was off for Totally Pauly.
So weirdly evangelical Christian themes for Totally Pauly. And then, this is actually a little bit of a this is an anticlimax. I think the weakest of the bunch was the Totally Pauly, Totally Stuffed Thanksgiving special.
Oh, was that Totally Pauly or it wasn't totally different?
I think it was. I think it was totally different Pauly. I was trying to figure out what year it was. I think it was 92. Because at one point he says...
Because we have a new president, a new outlook, and a new focus.
That was kind of the most interesting part to me is that this Totally Pauly episode also happened on
and we've also got
year.
A whole new America, for what it's worth. It's a little bit different, I think, than 92. But I feel like when I first... Because I've seen this on YouTube before. You know, we've been watching random Totally Pauly shit on YouTube all year. And I feel like when I first saw it, I assumed it was... part of the promotion for Son-in-Law, but that was 93. Mm-hmm. So I think this is actually pre-Son-in-Law. Maybe it's like he was filming Son-in-Law at the time.
I mean, it doesn't really have anything to do with Son-in-Law other than he has a cowboy hat. No, because like he's just on like a horse carriage and then talking to this guy whose name is,
his name is Buckshot. But Pauly keeps getting his name wrong, which is why we can't remember what his name actually was.
With my co-host, Buck Snort.
Buckshot.
I do like when they're talking about Native Americans. And,
if there's Indians out there, this show's for you guys as well. That's because if it wasn't for the Indians...
We wouldn't be here. I tell you, that they were, you know, they came first.
I'm like, well, I suppose that's an optimistic way of looking at things.
Yeah. Yeah, so he starts out on the thing with Buckshot on the horse-drawn carriage, and then he goes and talks to some ladies, girls, I guess. I think they might be like teenage girls who do the rodeo fucking bronco kind of stuff.
Yeah, like rodeo
show them how to do that. Then he talks to a lady and she shows him how to do some rope tricks.
Yeah, is that where he's running around her, tying her up and yelling at
Jeffrey Dahmer? Yes, I was just going to say, he makes a timely and very off-color Jeffrey Dahmer reference.
Like a Jeffrey Dahmer, man. Come on, Jeffrey Dahmer. Oh, buddy. Okay, we'll be back shortly, you guys.
Great.
Have a wonderful turkey day.
It's a totally different Pauly episode. I do think it's kind of interesting. Way back, we talked about Totally Pauly and Totally Different Pauly and the differences between them. These are a pretty good case study of the differences because Totally Pauly Thanksgiving was him very much in weasel mode, trying to mooch off of people and like complaining about his mom leaving him alone for the holidays. And then Totally Different Pauly is like fish out of water Pauly. It's like a Mr. Rogers where he goes to a workplace and learns about a job kind of a thing, you know? So they're good examples of the difference.
Yeah. I'm understanding the nuance between Totally Pauly and Totally Different Pauly more now that I've watched more.
Right. It's not the best episode I've seen. It's not the worst episode I've seen. One thing, this was meant to be a special, you know, I think it might've aired Thanksgiving Day. And so at the beginning of it, I was watching it today. At the last minute and he said something like for the next 2 hours. And I was like, oh, fuck, 2 hours. But it was actually it's 2 hours with music videos and commercials. In terms of actual the segments that we watched, it was like 20 minutes.
I wouldn't have sent that to you if it was 2 hours. I did check the time. Oh, one thing I forgot about, I can't remember which specific episodes it was for these, but the homeless shelter one, it was funny. Another thing that was funny about the not funny homeless shelter one, but that they have these people who are at like work, I think they were previously homeless people who are now working at the shelter or volunteering at the shelter, but he would be standing there with them and like interviewing them. And then he'd be like, okay, we're we're going to be here with this man who was previously on drugs. He's been sober for 4 months. And you're going to watch this Judas Priest video. Then it would presumably go to, like, I don't know, like something yeah. Turbo Lover or whatever. What was Judas Priest doing at that time?
Painkiller, maybe?
Or the Smash or Trash, I think, from... It might have been from the Homeless Shelter.
Jane's Addiction. Oh, I had one more thing to say about the Totally Stuffed Thanksgiving special. I did like that he tried to, like, make it a running. He was like,
Thanksgiving time. Right now, you guys are probably getting your first plate at Thanksgiving. You're sitting there with your family, and you're looking at that stepdad or that your sister's boyfriend that you're going, what are you doing here? You know, I mean, and stuff like that. And then you're looking at, you know what I mean? There's a lot of new family members around the table, but they're people, so be cool to them too, right?
And then later.
Happy Thanksgiving. You're on your sixth plate right now. People are banging on the bathroom door and going, open it up. Come on, it's my turn. Shut up. You know, that kind of stuff. He'll be right back.
You know, like he's trying to like create this narrative around where in Thanksgiving you currently are while you're watching the show.
We should play that in real time at our Thanksgiving. I should try to track down the videos that were played during that.
Try to reconstruct it.
As long as... make a playlist.
I wish that somebody would just air these programming blocks in full. I know it's impossible because of licensing and copyright and stuff, but I would love to just watch a Totally Pauly with the videos as it was originally aired, you know?
Me too. Or like even in the Homeless Shelter one, after Totally Pauly is a Yo MTV rap. So it's like it ends that segment and it's like, you know, Yo MTV rap is next. You zoom out from him standing there with all these previously homeless people.
But I mean, the real star of Pauly Shore Thanksgiving content is, of course, Son-in-Law, which you rewatched recently. I haven't gotten around to it yet.
I rewatched last night. Yeah, it's a new tradition.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, there's not really much to say. We already did a whole episode on it, but it still holds up. It's definitely one of the, it probably is the best movie that we've watched. Like by a long shot. I still stand by my outfit choice. His best outfit in that was 100% the outfit that he wears to the tattoo parlor with the tiny shorts that have the zebra print like motif. And I that was the part that really stuck out to me. I think we talked about this a little bit, but it's like Flea is a tattoo artist there. Just kind of weird because Pauly is supposed to be like this, like he's like everything that's alternative to the main like family or whatever. But he's so like weirdly against tattoos, like kind of like Puritan about them. It's very strange.
Yeah, it is interesting. You know, I don't think he has any tattoos. I wonder if that snuck into the script because he himself is against tattoos,
or it's like he improv that.
Yeah, so I'll watch it over the Thanksgiving break. I'll probably post some. I don't think I ever posted any clips from that episode because my promotion of this show is always extremely haphazard. So I'll probably put some clips up and we'll link it again and just make that a new Thanksgiving tradition.
Yeah, there's Home for the Holidays.
Yeah.
Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
Right.
Son-in-Law. The thing that's funny about Son-in-Law too is like, so Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, obviously like a lot of wacky stuff happens throughout the whole film, but the end like Thanksgiving scene is like like an iconic scene for Thanksgiving. I can't really remember a whole lot of Home for the Holidays, but I feel like it's the same thing. For Son-in-Law, the Thanksgiving dinner scene is where it's revealed that he and whatever her name was, date rape. They were given a date rape drug and like kidnapped and positioned so it looked like they had an affair. It's just such a bizarre culmination of the movie around the Thanksgiving holiday.
And then they like
that the dinner is
like rough up and throw out the bad guys. And the grandpa stands up and gives that speech in polybonics.
Yeah, I was just going to say polybonics. Yeah.
So it's really the best Thanksgiving movie.
Yeah, so make that part of your holiday tradition. Just try it. If you have to say grace in polybonics. See what happens.
So that's all I got today. This is a good mini-sode length.
Well, I have one more thing to say. It's not really related to Thanksgiving, but I know I said I was going to see Pauly Shore live, and that. I wanted to. Yeah, I wanted to. So he was in Royal Oak, I think, like two weeks ago or last weekend. I can't remember. It was just too expensive for me. I couldn't justify it. I couldn't really do it. I kind of like lost track of time after my cat passed away, and I missed the cheap tickets. So
it kind of came up. Fortunately, it came I didn't see Pauly Shore, but too. Like I remember.
Yeah, I thought it was the end of November. Too. I thought it was closer to my
birthday.
And then
it's like the election and just like, you know, just like too much going on.
Yeah, we might make it up by watching a live. Yeah. If you can find like some Pauly Shore live stuff, maybe that'll, because I imagine that the material isn't much different. So I'm sure that we could probably cover that in a future mini-sode. But yeah, unfortunately, I didn't get to see Pauly Shore close to my home.
Yeah. Well,
it's a shame. But I could not justify spending like $80 on two tickets to see Pauly Shore, even if I got to meet him. I'm sorry. not right now.
Like we said last time, though, we're kind of, the year of the weasel has an indefinite end point. So you never know. He might come back on tour. He seems to be constantly working. So I mean, he might come back at some point.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you, everybody, for watching. Watch Son-in-Law this weekend.
Hey, make your family watch it. If they're watching football, step in front of the television.
Put on Son-in-Law. Son-in-Law. Like right when the game is about to reach its decisive point. If you've got family and you're like, there's going to be weird, like political stuff. If like some of your family voted for Trump or whatever, put on Son-in-Law. And then that is all about healing culture divides. That's what the movie is about.
yeah maybe what we need to overcome white supremacy and the onset of fascism is to all watch Son-in-Law together.
We haven't, like, it's worth a try, right? Like in the meantime, you can connect with us on Instagram at DystopianGram, YouTube at Dystopian Dance Party, on the web at DystopianDanceParty.com. Find us on your podcast service of choice. Leave us a review if you haven't yet. And, oh, fuck, I forgot to mention last time, email us at HeyBuddy@DystopianDanceParty.com. And that's it. We'll be back in a couple weeks with a movie that I already forgot the title of. It's something about a curse. I don't know. It's something from 1997. We'll see. Bye.
Bye.
I just want to say happy Thanksgiving and get that second plate now. It's about time for the second plate. Stuff that you took a breather, you went outside, maybe had a smoke, a little vino, a little soda pop for the little ones. Stay tuned for the Totally Stuffed special on MTV. Happy Thanksgiving, you guys.
This is good.
Yeah!